Good day, this is Teutonicpenguin. Today I'll be giving a very general view of a basic armor kit, functions of different pieces, and where I got them. Starting out, I'm wearing full arming wear. I have a gambeson, or akatin. It's a padded jacket that absorbs the shock of blows and makes mail more comfortable to wear. I also have these padded cuisses with steel polons, light padding on the shins, and period footwear. First piece of armor to go on is the mail hauberk. This is a riveted shirt made from 18 gauge 8mm mild steel rings. I've attached ailettes from the 14th century, painted in a Templar style. They are tied directly to the sleeve of the mail shirt. Alright, now I'm outfitted in very basic arming wear and mail armor. You can also wear a coif and don a surcoat, but I also have these splinted armor pieces. Used in the 14th century, it's leather with steel plates riveted on. It was a fairly economic form of armor that eventually transitioned over to full plate. So I'll put these on. Alright, so now I've got full splint arms and splinted greaves, elbow cup for the rondel for extra protection. They are articulated and it includes a rebrace. Next we put on the padded collar and the riveted coif, or coif. This one has an added vent tail for extra protection. Put on the surcoat. This one is made of cotton and linen. Cotton was actually a natural historical fabric. Could have been imported from Egypt. Also have a belt with a pack. The surcoat acted as protection for the armor itself. Kept the sun off of it, the elements, dirt, mud. Also displayed heraldry. I have a woolen red cross of the Order of the Templar Knights. Also always put on my small wood cross. Arming sword. And heater shield with the Boussant colors, 2/3 white, 1/3 black. Might avoid with rawhide edge, double canvas layer, slight padding on the back, tacked on, leather strapping system, the shoulder strap. Can be worn on the shoulder like so and carried on the back. Finally, we have the gauntlets. These are not actually historical for this kit, but I needed the extra protection for combat and they match my splinted armor set. These are a hybrid between finger gauntlets and mitt gauntlets. They were what I could afford and they turned out very nice. Finally, we have the great helm, 14 gauge steel, cold rolled, with padding on the inside. And with that, I'm fully armored in Templar style, with complete padding, mail and splint armor, complete with sword and shield, and ailettes. Now I'm ready for battle. mobility in this kit is very good. Almost no restriction whatsoever. The arms articulate well. I can grip things with the gauntlets. Legs are not restricted. It's overall a very light kit, just mild splints and padding. Some other kits have full steel and they are a bit heavier, or they can be tempered and be just as strong but a lot lighter. Most of the armor is made from 14 or 16 gauge steel. The ailettes and shields are made from plywood with canvas glued on and tacked around the back. The arming wear is made from heavy cotton canvas and padded with wool, and that basically sums it up. So I'll just go over where I got some of the pieces. The period footwear came from Viking Leather Crafts. The splinted arms and legs came from a maker named John McCrossan. The padded cuisse with metal pollen came from Medieval Collectibles. They were made by Get Dressed for Battle. The padded gambeson I bought used from eBay is made by Get Dressed for Battle. The mail hauberk came from All Best Stuff. The surcoat I got on a trade, it came from Cult of Athena. The coif was from All Best Stuff. The eyelets I made myself, along with the shield. The helm is from Arm Street. The sword I got from a shop at the Bristol Renaissance Fair called Mayhawk Armory. And the arming cap and cross I made myself. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. As always, comment, subscribe, and thanks for watching.